Okay, you're here because you want to put text or an image behind someone or something. You want it to look good, but you don't want to spend a lot of time on it. I've got answers. What's up, everybody? Ian here, back with another very exciting episode of Learn How to Edit Stuff. And yes, we are going to talk about compositing today, doing it very quickly, doing it very efficiently, and getting you on the path to the best looking result as fast as we possibly can. So for today's lesson, we're going to be using After Effects in collaboration with Runway ML. I find that After Effects kind of gives you the best result, looks really nice, super, super easy. But if you guys want to do this in Adobe Premiere, I will show you at the very end of the video how to achieve something similar in Premiere. Very easy, especially when you use Runway ML. So let's dive into it, get started right now. You're gonna go to runwayml.com. And if you guys don't have an account, just click on sign up and you can sign in with Google to get a free account. Don't look at my email address, you psychopaths. And that will throw you into Runway ML. It's that simple. Just sign in with Google, now you're in. Now you have a free account. It does say get access to 4K exports, PNG exports, and longer scenes if you upgrade. But for this tutorial and this lesson, we don't need to upgrade. We can use the free version. Like and subscribe for free stuff. Smash that thumb, drop a comment in the comments. Okay, so you're in Runway ML, and the first thing we're gonna do is go to our assets folder, and then we are going to upload a file from our computer. And I have this video right here of these fitness people doing fitnessy things and posing as fitness people do with their muscles and their low body fat. New Year's Eve's right around the corner. Are you guys making your resolutions? Okay, so our video is just about done uploading here, and now it is uploaded. So let's go to green screen and let's take that fitness video and just drag it right down here onto our timeline at the very bottom. And we are very, very simply going to click on our actors in our scene, just like that. And Runway ML will do its machine learning crazy AI thing and basically rotoscope them out. We're missing a little part of his pants here, but look, three clicks, guys, four clicks. We're gonna get his fingers, four clicks on the fingers, maybe five clicks so that we can get a little bit more of the hair here. And now Runway ML has done an amazing job of rotoscoping out our fitness models within a matter of seconds. All right, this was all done in real time. I did a little picture-in-picture effect just to show you how effective this is. And we're done. That's basically all we have to do. I'll put a video card on screen for my previous video that I did on Runway ML. It's a fantastic AI machine learning editing tool for you guys out there. But we're done, all right? So if you grab too much of your background, you can exclude. We did the inclusion and we're gonna feather it just one pixel. And now we're done. We're gonna go to export mask and we're going to export it with a green screen in SD, which is 640 by 360. It is a little bit low resolution, but I'm gonna show you guys a little hack inside of After Effects to get us a 1080 export. Don't tell Runway that I know this information. Anyway, SD, green screen. We could export with an alpha channel if we upgraded, right? I have an upgraded account, but for you guys out there that wanna do this for free, quick and easy, I got you covered. So we're gonna export that mask and it is going to export this green screen video into our assets folder. So we're just gonna wait patiently while this processes. And once it's done processing, we can click on these three little dots, go to download and download it somewhere onto your computer. We're gonna put it in my videos folder. Then we are going to open up After Effects and then grab that export that we just did right there and bring it into After Effects. And now we have our green screen version and the original version. So with the original version selected, I'm going to drag and drop that onto the composition button to create a new composition exactly the length and the dimensions of my source video. Then I'm going to put the green screen version on top of it. It is very small because it is low quality. So let's right click on that guy, go to transform and fit to comp. So it will make it the same size as our composition. And now let's just add a giant wall of text. You know, we'll align it, we'll make it look real nice. And now we basically have all of the pieces of the puzzle that we need to get this done. So let's mute the text for now. And on our green screen layer, come up to your effects and presets and search key. And then you're gonna drop the last one down here, key light and advanced spill suppressor onto your green screen video. Now take your eyedropper, grab the background, change this from intermediate result to screen matte. Then tool down the screen matte icon, change the clip black value to 25 and the clip white value to 75, which is gonna create a nice little matte for us right there, looking real pretty. Go back to intermediate result. You'll see that there's a green halo around our actor and actress, but that's okay. Just turn on the advanced spill suppressor right next to it right there, and that green line will go away. Now, I know what you're thinking. Ian, if I take my giant wall of text and I just put it underneath my green screen asset, doesn't that do exactly what we want it to do? Well, yes and no. Yes, the text is behind them. No, because it's the low res video and the pixel density is like dramatically different. If I turn this on and off, you can see the clarity in the original source video versus the free asset that we get out of Runway ML. But don't worry, I've got hacks. So what we're gonna do is we're going to turn on our wall of text, and we're going to turn the track mat on our wall of text to alpha inverted green screen fitness SD parentheses 1.mp4. And what that's gonna do is it's going to reference our green screen layer, which is low quality, to mask out the text. And it's gonna follow all the movement and everything. And even though it's low quality, we're still getting the nice pixel density and clarity from the original source video while retaining our mask and matte from the Runway ML export. Now, if you guys really want to, you can come in here and you can pixel peep this and say, oh, well, it's a little bleedy into our heady. Okay, great. So come to our green screen clip. We're gonna search for simple choker inside of After Effects, drop a simple choker on there, and then you can kind of choke the mat a little bit. I kind of found that negative 0.5 works pretty well, maybe negative 0.6. And that should look pretty good there. Nobody's really gonna be zooming in that far on your video, but we have essentially done what is a very difficult task to do in After Effects or otherwise in a matter of seconds, just by 5 simple clicks on Runway ML, exporting that asset and then using that asset as a track mat on our text layer. And we've done the impossible in a matter of minutes. How long is this tutorial? I don't know, pretty short though, okay? You could do the same thing using RotoBrush 2 inside of After Effects, but it takes a lot longer and it's significantly more annoying because you have to like go frame by frame and make sure that it's not getting anything, and then you have to freeze it, and then you have to, it's too much. Okay, it's too much. Runway ML, ML stands for machine learning, AI, video editing, and enhancement technology that you can just use to save a bunch of time and get an amazing looking result in just very few clicks for free because I showed you a hack today. Make sure you like and subscribe, drop a comment in the comment section below. Let me know if you learned anything impressive or exciting in this video tutorial. And that's it. So you can use text, you could use animated text, you can use a picture, you can use a video, explosions, whatever you want to put behind these fitness people. Maybe some cakes, right? Because they can't eat them, and it would just be a funny joke for you with the low body fat percentage. New Year's is right around the corner. Oh, I told you I would do this in Premiere as well. So let's do that in Premiere. You've done it in After Effects. Congratulations. Everything is great. Export your video as normal. Now let's go into Adobe Premiere where I have everything already set up to save a little bit of time. So our green screen layer and then a giant wall of text, different font this time, and then the original source video. So what we're gonna do is in our effects inside of Premiere, we are going to search Ultra Key and drop an ultra key on that top video there. And very simply in our effect controls, grab the eyedropper and grab the background. It actually does a weirdly better job than After Effects for some reason, but we're not here to debate it. Okay, so now on our giant wall of text, oh, just kidding. On our green screen layer, we are going to search for brightness and contrast. And we are going to drop a regular brightness and contrast on that green screen. Turn the brightness up to 100 and the contrast down to -100 because we are essentially creating a fake matte inside of Adobe Premiere. And then on our text layer, we are going to search for matte. Nope, that's not how you spell it. Matte with 2 T's. And we are going to drop a track matte key right onto our text layer. And then we're going to set that text layer to look at video 3 as our layer and then click this little reverse button. And we have done the exact same thing inside of Adobe Premiere that we did in After Effects, and our mask looks great. And it took us literally no time at all using a low resolution asset from Runway ML that I hacked because learn how to edit stuff. We always try to figure out a way around things. But yeah, we did it both ways in Adobe Premiere, which looks really great. And in After Effects, which also looks great. You could track the background in After Effects to make it look even that much better in a matter of seconds. Do you want to do it? All right, let's do it. Fine. Fine, you convinced me because we have so much time in this tutorial because we save so much time using this version of it. Okay, so let's quickly go to our fitness layer here, go to our tracker, and then I'm just going to track the camera in our scene. I'm going to let After Effects analyze this and just do its thing. And then once it solves the camera in your scene, we're going to find somewhere in the background that looks nice. This little desk thing is suspicious with the plant. What is this set that they're in? Anyway, click on one where the thing is facing the camera. We're going to right click, go to create solid and camera, which will, you guessed it, create a solid and a camera. We're going to take that solid, hit P on the keyboard to copy the position data, copy that onto our text layer, which we now need to make 3D. So click the little 3D button there and hit P and then paste the position value onto our text. Let's mute this real quick. Let's bring our text back in. And now we just have to scale it into our scene accordingly. And now we have created a 3D camera with our 3D text solid. It is in the background. And with it rendered, if we scrub through, you can see our text is now tracked to the camera movement in our scene. Everything looks great. Our actors are in front of our text. It only took us 5 clicks. It all looks really clean. We didn't have to use RotoBrush 2. And you liked and subscribed to this YouTube channel and dropped a comment in the comment section below because you know you're not finding any other gems like this from any of these other channels on YouTube. Maybe you are, but I like to think that I'm special. Anyways, thank you so much for watching this video. Go check out Runway ML. I will put a link in the video description below for you to sign up with a free account. Do what we did today. Use it as a track mat. Put it into your scene. Composite it all together because you're a badass and ain't nobody telling you nothing. There's also links to my social media accounts and a bunch of downloads and a link tree with all the AE juice and all that fun stuff. Runway ML is going in there. Everything's in there. Everything that I care about and I hold near and dear to my heart is in that Linktree link. So go check it out. Give this video a thumbs up. Comment below. Subscribe. Drink water. Have a happy holiday season. And I will see you in the next one.